We're starting to close phase two, the snowstorm, and now the blizzard is going to give us round three, which is where we're going to have to talk about and address the cold that's ahead. Good news here. I'm just going to actually step back and let you see it for yourself. This is Storm View Doppler radar. Remember, the darker the blue, the more likely we're talking heavy snow. And that area of the screen now shrunk down between Marshall, Sedalia, Windsor, going down toward east of Whiteman Air Force Base. So the heavy torrential, if you will, snow seems to be a thing of the past, at least as far as it being as widespread as it was. I-70 still closed in both directions. There's that heavy snow, which is still moving away. On the Kansas side, still some snow that's falling, but from Garnett to farther south toward Wichita, seems to be that this line is shrinking too. Take a look at this on the wider spans. And yeah, it's falling apart a little bit toward Maryville and up toward Falls City, Nebraska. Lighter amounts of snow, eastern portions of Kansas. Western Missouri still getting the brunt of it, though. And as you see here in the last few frames, not as much real estate covered with that heavy snow. But we're still going to see a couple more hours at least. I think it'll all be done by, say, midnight or so for everybody. Teens, for your temperatures, your wind chills, you know, are going to be much lower than that. Here's our City View camera, and we kept it on the same shot just to see once again how the visibilities have been going, sometimes up, sometimes down. You saw with some of our reporters, whiteout conditions across the region. If you look carefully, yeah, there's still a little bit of snow falling, to say the least. Mostly horizontal, as it's been all day today. Blizzard warning remains in effect until Wednesday afternoon for the immediate metro until about 6 o'clock. But you go out to the west of us, so like that'd be Clay County, it's up until about 6 in the morning. You go a little farther to the east, heading towards, say, Sheridan County and Carroll counties, you're under the warning until noon or so. So it will finally clear out, at least from this. The gusty winds that are taking over, 30-mile-an-hour wind gust in St. Joseph, 36 miles an hour in Lawrence, and we still have the winds still coming out of the north all across the area, so it's not the best, which is why our wind chills are down below zero, three below. Kansas City, Belton, -3. Lawrence and Paola the same. Double digits, minus, like -10, down toward Emporia. There it is, lifting out more in the way of lighter snows. It'll be overhead, and according to FutureScan, picking it up at 7 o'clock, it's going to be piecemeal by midnight or so. This lifts out, but not before dropping all the snow that we've been talking about, with the heaviest still to the southeast of the city itself. Lawrence picking up just under 11 inches, 12 plus here in Kansas City. A little farther to the east, it looks like things are going to once again improve a little bit. After a while, it's going to take some time to clear out, but once again, you go farther northwest, 6 to 7 inches amounts of snow. Farther to the southeast, that's where the heaviest is. And the reports are still coming in here. As a matter of fact, I just got an email here, Aaron. This one coming in from Barney Carroll, Western Shawnee, between, say, K7 and Shawnee Mission Parkway, already 13 inches of snow on the ground.
And I think the highest report within our viewing area has been Warrensburg so far. 21 inches of snow, Sedalia 16, and for most of the 435 loop, especially the southeastern half, at least a foot of snowfall. So where we have concern is tomorrow, although the snow will be ending, as you said, after midnight. Once we see all those winds continuing to gust and blow and drift that snow, we are anticipating hazardous roadways for at least the first half, if not all of tomorrow, across the bulk of our viewing area. In terms of temperatures, Bryan, that is the other side of the story with this storm. 2 in the morning, 4 at lunchtime, 8 degrees tomorrow afternoon, and another chance for snowfall we'll be tracking, Bryan, as we head towards the weekend. You have more on that.
Yeah, unfortunately, the 7-day forecast could not go without a blemish. We have another storm that we have to worry about, smaller in scope. That's the good news. But temperatures very, very cold. -12 to 5 above, 19 on Friday. Saturday, the atmosphere gets juiced up again with temperatures closer to 30 degrees. A brief thaw before another chance of light snow late Sunday into Monday. Temperatures dropping once again, 15 to 24 on Monday, 5 above to 20 degrees on Tuesday. But right now, it looks like this storm system, no comparison between the blizzard we have overhead right now.